Okay. So last session we have stopped here, where we had derived the equation for maximum velocity Cmax. Actually, it is not a derivation; it is only simplifying the equation. So first of all, we have reference velocity is other, that is velocity of sound, velocity of fluid, stagnation velocity, maximum velocity, critical velocity. These are the reference velocities we are studying. So localized sound A equal to root gamma r t, that we have already studied. Fluid C also, m equal to C by A. Then stagnation velocity A naught, I explained that A naught equal to root gamma r T naught. Maximum velocity C max, that I have explained last session, that is C max equal to, from that equation only, H plus E square by 2, that is the equation for Adiabatic equation. So if enthalpy or temperature equal to zero, that equation becomes, the whole energy will be of that kinetic energy, that is maximum velocity of maximum velocity is the maximum velocity versus maximum kinetic energy. So C max, H equal to 0, T equal to 0 is the condition for maximum velocity. So H equal to 0, T equal to 0 in the condition is that, therefore the equation for C max equal to root 2 H naught, root 2 H naught. Or we can say another equation, that is C max by A naught equal to root 2 by gamma minus 1, that we had derived from simple explanation, root 2 Cp D naught, that we have substitute for CPS, gamma by gamma minus 1 into R. Then we have simplified the equation into C max by A naught equal to root 2 by gamma minus 1. Then gamma, this the value of gamma will be there in every module. So, okay, every module you want to study the value of gamma and value of Mach number. So gamma, actually we are taking, or generally we are taking this gamma as 1.4. Gamma as 1.4, that is a standard value of air. Majority of the question will be asking based on the properties of air. Okay, the gamma is 1.4. In some other rare condition, gamma equal to 1.3 will be also asking. So gamma equal to 1.4 and gamma equal to 1.3 will be your main perspective for your problem. So value of gamma will be there in your problem. Gamma to 1.4 or 1.3, etc. Just want to take the particular table. If it is Fano table, if it is Rayleigh table, if it is isentropy table, if it is normal shock table, take the table and of gamma 1.4 or gamma 1.3, take the readings, just do the problem. That is the method of doing problem in your first module, sorry, CF of all modules. So then we have study about critical velocity of sound. Critical velocity of sound. As I said, critical velocity of sound is equal to C star, is also called A star, which means at a critical velocity, fluid velocity equal to cell velocity of sound. Fluid velocity equal to velocity of sound. At a critical state, we are denoting them a very symbol as star condition, raised to star, C star equal to A star, like that. So critical velocity C star equal to A star is also, I have accepted that at that condition, Mach number equal to 1. Okay, Mach number equal to 1. So M critical can be explained as M critical equal to T star by A star is also equal to 1. Okay. Then here C star equal to A star equal to root gamma R T star. T star equal to A star equal to root gamma R T star. That is the explanation for critical velocity at a critical state. Okay. Then what is the equation for that particular T naught, or T naught something like that, critical velocity? That is, only changing value is T naught by T equal to 1 plus gamma minus 1 by 2 m square. That is our normal stagnation state equation. Stagnation's temperature equation, T naught by T equal to 1 plus gamma minus 1 into m square. What is this equation becomes when it is in critical stage? What is the change occurs in this equation when the property moves into a critical stage? At a critical stage, T equal to T star, right? T equal to T star. What is Mach number m? M equal to 1. Okay, at a critical stage, T equal to T star and M equal to 1. So the equation becomes T naught by T star equal to, this is the method to find the value of critical temperature. Okay, if T naught is given or any other is given, we can find the value of T star directly from here. T naught by T star equal to 1 plus gamma minus 1 by 2. 1 plus gamma minus 1 only, because m equal to 1. So m square equal to 1, but m will be not there. So we can simplify this equation. LHS 1 plus gamma minus 1 by 2. Multiply 2, cross multiply, and actually inventor gave the 2 into 1 plus gamma minus 1 whole divided by 2. Then 2 into 1 is 2. 2 plus gamma minus 1 by 2. 2 minus 1 equal to 1. Therefore, the equation is gamma plus 1 by 2. Gamma plus 1 by 2. So the equation for critical temperature, it is T naught by T star equal to gamma plus 1 by 2. T naught by T star. To find the value of T star, you can use this equation as T naught by T star equal to gamma plus 1 by 2. Okay. That is the properties of reference velocities. Reference velocities A, C, A naught, C max, and C star or A star. These are the conditions. Okay. Then there is another type of Mach number you can see in your textbook, that is M star. So you will have a doubt that if it is a Mach number for critical state, it's not a Mach number for critical state. All properties except Mach number raised to star, all properties denoted by M star, T star, C star, P star, etc., other than M star is critical state. M star is not in critical state. Critical state on the M critical itself. M critical itself is equal to C star by A star. It is not M star. Mach number value than another, other critical state, the Mach number, it is not M star. So, M star is another type of Mach number. It is defined by a non dimensional fluid, it is defined as the ratio of fluid velocity to velocity at critical state. Fluid velocity to velocity at critical state. Or you can write C by A star, because C star equal to A star. So, another type of Mach number, M star, can be defined as a non-dimensional term, which can be defined as the ratio of fluid velocity to velocity at critical state. C by C star or C by A star. C by C star or C by A star. And this Mach number is very convenient. M star is very convenient to use because of two features. That is, at a high, it is used because at a high fluid velocities, M approaches infinity. At high fluid velocities, Mach number approaches to infinity. If C value is very high and A value is very small, M equal to C by A, then the value will be in infinity. Okay. C value will be in infinity. Anga condition M star uveka. At fluid velocity, m equal to infinity. Therefore, we can use at that condition, at a higher fluid velocity, we can use m equal to c by c star. And second feature is, m is not proportional to fluid velocity alone. M is not proportional to fluid velocity alone. Because it depends on velocity of sound too. Like m equal to c by a. M can be depend upon C or either A. If A increases, M value decreases. If A decreases, M value increases. It also depend upon the velocity of sound too. Okay. Then M equal to C by C star is only depend upon the fluid velocity itself. M by C by A star is there, but both are same. C star equal to A star and the same as on the anything. So M is not proportional to fluid velocity alone. So here M star is only depend upon the fluid velocity. So, depend upon the two features, it is very convenient to use M star in some conditions because of the two features. Okay, so, defined as the ratio of fluid velocity to velocity at critical state. Okay. That is the condition for using m star. Then these are the velocities and reference velocities that we have already studied. Moving to next topic, we want to study about what changes occurs when Mach number changes. If Mach number is less than 1 or very small, what is the change in the fluid? If Mach number is equal to 1, what is the change? If Mach number is very higher, what is the changes? So according to change in Mach number, what is the change occur? So according to that condition, we can define several flow of fluid. If Mach number very less than 1, we can say it is something NM fluid. If Mach number is increasing, we can say another type of fluid, etc. According to the value of Mach number, we can define a fluid into several ways. Okay, that is the next topic. It's very simple because if M is very less than 1, M is very less than 1, that is M equal to C by A is our equation. M very less than 1 means if the value of C is very small. The value of C is very small and the value of A is higher than A. It is called incompressible flow. Incompressible flow. When M is less than 1, that is very, very nearer to 1, we can say it is subsonic flow. Subsonic flow. Subsonic. M very much less than 1, it is incompressible flow. M less than 1, we can say it is a subsonic flow. Then M equal to 1, we can say sonic flow. Subsonic flow. Sonic flow. Then M greater than 1, we can say supersonic flow. Then M very much greater than 1, we can say it is a hypersonic flow. Please note down the values. Please note down the So M very much less than 1, it is incompressible flow. When M less than 1, it is subsonic flow. In the problem, it is asking that a supersonic flow of a jet engine or a supersonic flow of a gas. This means that the Mach number is very much greater than 1. A sonic flow. A sonic flow means M equal to 1. M equal to, it is not, it will be a critical state or a throat. Endu aavam alle. M equal to 1, subsonic flow, which means C equal to A. Here, C very much less than A. If C less than A, C equal to A, C greater than A, C very much greater than A. That is the conditions. If C equal to A, two both velocity is equal, we can say it's a sonic flow. These are the main thing you want to study. Okay. Then how we can represent this particular flow in a graph? Sonic flow, subsonic flow. So there is a small 3 to 5 step derivation is there to reach into the graph. To plot the whole sonic, subsonic, transonic, hypersonic, etc. in a particular graph, we want to derive a small equation, that is various regions of flow. The question, university question, various regions of flow. Derivation of figure of arcane. This is the university question. Various regions of flow. Various regions of flow. It is a derivation based on the velocity C and A. It is the adiabatic energy equation. Adiabatic energy equation on the chain. Adiabatic equation is changing to another term by in the terms of C and A. Adiabatic energy equation is H plus C square by 2 equal to H2 plus C square, C2 square by 2. C1 square is our equation. So we have derived an equation for stagnation enthalpy in the previous session, that is H0 equal to H plus half C square or C square by 2. Put it as a constant. Adiabatic flow. For an adiabatic flow, H0 equal to constant. So we can take h naught equal to h plus half c square equal to constant. H naught equal to h plus half c square equal to constant. Then substitute the values for h equal to cpt. H naught equal to cpt naught. What will be the change in the equation? Cpt naught equal to cpt plus half c square, right? Half c square. That is h naught cpt naught equal to cpt plus half c square. Put the first equation equal to 1. H naught equal to h plus half c square equal to, and h equal to cpt. H equal to cpt, you can also rewrite as h equal to cpt equal to gamma by gamma minus 1 into rt. Gamma by gamma minus 1 into rt. Okay. Then this equation, okay, h equal to cpt equal to gamma by gamma minus 1 rt. Here gamma rt is there. Gamma rt is there. So we can write this equation as a square by gamma minus 1, right? A square by gamma minus 1. H. H equal to a square by gamma minus 1. That's right. Root gamma rt is there. Gamma rt is equal to a square. A equal to root gamma t, therefore gamma t equal to a square by gamma minus 1 is the. Then also we can write gamma by gamma minus 1 to rt analo, this equation. Then what is rho equal to p by rt, rho equal to p by rt. Rho equal to p by rt. We already know the equation, rho density equal to p by rt. Then here rt is the, substitute rt for p by rho. P by rho equal to rt. P by rho equal to rt. P by rho equal to rt. Substitute here. One equation got t equal to one equation got a money jana chino. P by rho equal to rt. Therefore, cp h equal to gamma by gamma minus 1 into p by rho. Gamma by gamma minus 1 into p by rho. Okay. There are two equations. H equal to a square by gamma minus 1. H equal to a square by gamma minus 1 is also equal to gamma by gamma minus 1 into p by rho. Right? H equal to a square by gamma minus 1 and also equal to gamma by gamma minus 1 into p by rho. H equal to cp into t. That derivation. H equal to cp into that equation. Substitute the value of h in this equation. H in this one. Substitute the value of h in this equation. First one only. Right. First one in this equation. That is h naught equal to h a square by gamma minus 1 plus half c square equal to constant. Put this equation number 2 and put this equation number 3. So first of all, we have wrote the equation for stagnation enthalpy, that is h naught equal to h plus half c square equal to constant. Thereafter, we have taken an equation, that is h for h, h equal to cp into t, that is gamma by gamma minus 1 r into t, and we have written two equations for h, h equal to a square by gamma minus 1 equal to gamma by gamma minus 1 into p by rho. Equation number 2. Thereafter, we had taken the first one, A H equal to A square gamma minus 1, and substituted in the equation number 1. That is, H naught equal to A square by gamma minus 1 plus half C square equal to constant. Okay. Take that equation only. H naught equal to A square by gamma minus 1 into plus. Then put at T equal to 0. Conditions. First two conditions. At T equal to 0. H equal to 0, right? and t equal to 0, h equal to 0, c equal to c max. That is the maximum velocity condition. H equal to 0, t equal to 0, c equal to 0. Equation 3 becomes, what is equation number 3? This equation becomes h naught equal to that a, what is the value going to cancel? T equal to 0, h equal to 0. Therefore, that the first part is h, right? The h like h and substitute that value becomes 0. Then h naught equal to half c max square. H naught equal to half c max square equal to constant. H naught equal to half c max square equal to constant, which means h equal to 0. Here h is equal to a square by gamma minus 1 equal to 0. You will get the equation of this condition. Then second condition is when c equal to 0. We are applying two conditions. First one is h equal to 0. Then c equal to 0, velocity 0. Then velocity 0, a equal to a naught. Was stagnation condition. When velocity c equal to 0, we can say a equal to a naught. C equal to 0, a equal to a naught. C equal to 0, a equal to a naught. Substitute in the particular equation, in this equation itself. In equation number 3, and a equal to 0, which means first part a equal to a naught, c equal to 0, second part is 0 here. Second velocity c equal to 0, then this part is 0, and first part only remains, that is h naught equal to a naught square by gamma minus 1. This is 4 and this is 5. H naught equal to a naught by gamma minus 1. So take, we have written three equations for h naught. Three equations for h naught. Equation number 3, 4, and 5. First one is equation number 3, which means h naught equal to a square by gamma minus 1 plus half c square equal to constant. It is the first equation. Then h naught equal to half c max square is second one, and h naught equal to a square by gamma minus 1 equal to the third. We have written three equations for h naught. So from 3, 4, and 5, both for h naught, we can write h naught equal to a square by gamma minus 1 plus half c square equal to half c max square equal to a naught square by gamma minus 1. Okay, this is the equation for a various regions of flow. Equation number 6. Okay. Just we have written the enthalpy equation and we have made a change. H in substitution go to. Then two conditions are taken. First one is h equal to 0 or t equal to 0. Then second condition is c equal to 0 and a equal to a naught. We have written three equations for h naught. And the three equations we have written in the same line. Equal to, equal to, equal to. This is the equation. A naught by a square by gamma minus 1 plus half c square equal to half c max square equal to n by n. By applying various values for C and A. By applying various values. When we open 1 for A and C, 2, 3, etc., 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 you will get a graph. That is our graph. By applying various values for C and A and plotting C versus A. By applying various values for C and A and plotting C versus A, we will get a graph, that is C here and A here. Is a very important graph. Okay. We will get a curve like this. We will get a curve like this. A in y-axis and C in x-axis. By applying various values, you see, you will get a graph. Then here, first part is incompressible flow, very small part. Okay. Then next part is subsonic. Then third part is transonic or sonic. Sonic, subsonic, incompressible. Sonic, then supersonic, and hypersonic. That is, here m is equal to v less than 1, here m equal to 1, and here m equal to greater than 1. That is, when c value is very much low and a value is very high. Adalle njan parna condition alle, m equal to c by a. When m equal to very much low, that is c is very much higher, very much lower, and a is higher, we will get m very much less than 1, it is incompressible flow. Then when c increases, approaches to 1, we will get a value here, the subsonic. When c increases, when c equal to a, it is middle of the condition of the middle of the graph, c equal to a, we will get a value called m equal to 1 is sonic flow. When a, when a, c increases and a decreases, we will get a flow supersonic. This m greater than, slightly greater than 1. When m very much greater than 1, we will get hypersonic. This is a very important graph. Just by logic, we can draw the graph, that is C A and A, M, C, E, equation which is the graph where I come with. When M very much less than to a point, when C A is in a point, 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 incompressible, subsonic, sonic, supersonic, and hypersonic flow. Then what are the, these all flows? That is the, what is incompressible flow, what is subsonic flow, what is sonic flow, what is supersonic flow, and what is hypersonic flow. Incompressible flow is a region very closest to A-axis. That is the explanations. What is incompressible flow? That is incompressible flow. Very closer to, it is a very, very closer to A-axis. And here A is, A means A, sound velocity is very much greater than, is very much this explanation. If you mention matram more than very much greater than fluid velocity, and in that condition the flow is known as incompressible flow, very much equal to x-axis. And what is subsonic flow? Subsonic flow, when a c is very much closer to a but less than a, c is very much closer to a but less than a, then Mach number is here, Mach number is very much less than 1, and in subsonic m is less than 1 because c is slightly less than a, then Mach number is less than a region flow is known as subsonic flow. Then sonic flow, what is sonic flow? Sonic flow is a region where m value is equal to 1 and c is equal to a, fluid velocity equal to velocity of sound, fluid velocity equal to velocity of sound. That is the condition of sonic flow. And what is supersonic flow? Supersonic flow is the flow where m value will be greater than 1, that is c value is greater than velocity of fluid is increasing to a stage greater than velocity of sound, is known as supersonic flow. Then what is hypersonic flow? So when the question is asking to derive the equation and to represent the whole flows in a graph or ellipse, ellipse is a part on it. Then it is an ellipse, representation of various flow region in ellipse. So represent the various flow region in ellipse. If the question is asking like that, you just draw the figure, the graph, and represent the whole flows, and you want to also explain the each and every term, incompressible, subsonic, sonic, supersonic, etc., etc., etc. Then hypersonic, m very much greater than a, that is c very much greater than a. It is very much closer to x-axis, closer to x-axis means c-axis. That is the explanations of the various flow region. Okay, so please try to understand what I am saying, and please make a thorough knowledge about the topic that I am in. You want to rewind and watch the video again in the YouTube. I will upload this video in today itself. You want, you can rewind the video once again and make a clear idea about what is the process we have taken in the last few hours. If any doubts is there, ask me. Okay, I will clarify it. So that is all about this session.